Let us look at some of the tips related to blood relations and family tree. The first and most important tip is draw the diagram, okay? Draw the diagram. It is very important. Whatever question has been given, it is much better to draw the diagram, the family tree, okay? This over here, then the children and all that stuff, so that it becomes very easy to solve the question, right? Now, the second tip is every generation should be on a new row, okay? So if this is the first generation of father and mother, the children should come on a new row so that you will understand that this is the previous generation, this is the present generation, then the next generation will come over here, okay? So every generation on a new level, right? Now, the third tip, which is another, again, an important tip, and that is use of symbols, okay? There should be use of symbols, and the symbols must be very, very simple so that it becomes very quick to draw them as well as remember them. For example, for male, if we denote plus, and for female, if we denote minus, then it becomes very easy to know which, how many people are males, how many are females in a family or how many in a group, like that. Also, like for example, there is a husband and a wife. Now, this is the male, okay, and this is female, and you want to show that they are husband and wife. So we can use a dash to show that they are married together. And if they have children, you can show like this, okay? There are, these people have two children. There's a boy and there's a girl, okay? So you can do, you can use symbols like this to denote family members and the previous generation and the present generation. Again, boy is male, so plus, girl is a female, so minus, right? So use such symbols, okay? You can, before going to exam, you can have the symbols decided, okay? Decide on the symbols, what you are going to use, okay? And I'll show you now how to decide on the symbols or how to remember the symbols, right? Before going on to sums, I'll tell you how to remember the symbols or decide on symbols. And remember these symbols, you'll use this for every sum henceforth, even in the exam, okay? Now the next tip that we are going to see, it is nothing but that no useless relations, okay? I mean, not useless, I mean the relations which are there, which are not there generally, like girlfriend, boyfriend, this is not asked in the exam. So don't think about it, that how do I denote my girlfriend and how do I show my boyfriend and how do I show my friends and family friends and all that stuff. That is not needed. Again, a husband having two wives, not allowed. Absolutely not allowed. So no such relations are there in exam. So do not consider these relations. Don't even think about this. Okay. Just focus on whatever is given in the exam. The next tip which is there is we try to judge the gender of a person from the name. Okay, like if we say Maya, we generally say, okay, she might be a female, but no, she can be a male or he can be a male or she can be a female. It can be anything. Like another example is Kiran. Okay, then we can have Michael. Michael, some of the people sometimes pronounce it as Michelle or something like that, and they write it as Michael. So you do not judge the gender based on names. It would give you the wrong answer. Okay, no assumptions. Now, next and the most important thing that would be very, very important to learn blood relations, how to solve blood relations, is to draw your own family diagram first. Okay, your own family tree. What does that mean? Whenever you are learning blood relations, it's not drawing your own family tree in exam. It is whenever you're learning blood relations at first, draw your own family tree using all the symbols. Okay, once you use the symbols on your family tree, it would be very easy for you to remember what symbol represents what relation. So over here, I'll try to draw my family tree, okay, over here, and based on that, let us move ahead, okay? Let us cement or concretize some symbols over here right now, and based on that, we'll solve all the sums. Now, I have a father, okay, then there's mother, right? So this is male, this is female, and they are married to each other. So I'll denote a dash for representing married people. I'll write it again over here, father, mother, okay? Plus, minus, male, female, and a dash to denote that they are married. Now they have, right, they have two children, okay, three children. So here there are two boys and a girl. So, okay, the girl is eldest, okay, then there's the first boy, then there's the second boy, right? Now there's no need to denote the eldest person at the start. You can have the eldest person anywhere. It is just for saying, I said that if they have the eldest girl and all this. Now, then the girl is married to, okay, this is her husband, okay, let us say HG, husband of the girl, male, okay, again, they have a small, they have two babies, two twins, right, both are, say, girls, again, so minus, minus. So, here we see that the next generation over here, we have denoted by what, this next level. Okay, next level is next generation. Husband, wife, y dash, and there is minus sign for female and plus sign for male. This is my mother, okay, and this is the father. F, this is father, right? So plus for male. Now there's another relation which you should know, and that is nothing but siblings. Now many a times it might happen that you might not be able to decipher anything from based on this. So whenever we want to denote two people as siblings, or brother sister, or brother brother, or sister sister, what we'll do is we are going to use a arrow, both sided arrow. That means both of them are siblings. So what all symbols we have concretized right now? Plus is for male, okay? Minus is for female, right? Okay, plus is for male, minus is for female. Then for married it is dash, and for siblings it is like this. What it is? It is double arrow. Now let us use these symbols and try to solve the sum. Okay, now before moving to sums related to blood relations, we'll first take a look at few important relations. You absolutely have to know these relations, because unless and until you know them, you won't be able to solve any of the sums. Okay, most of you know the relations, it is just a revision. Okay, let's see what are the important ones. You need to read all of them. I'll just show you what all the are most important. Father of father or mother is grandfather. Then the mother of your parents, that is mother of your father or mother, is grandmother. Okay, then you'll have brother of your father is uncle, sister of your father is aunt, right? Now let's move on to other important relations, but please take a look at these. Okay, you read all of them. I'll move on to the next set of relations. Brother or sister of your mother is nothing but maternal uncle or maternal aunt. Sometimes the word maternal is not given, it is only uncle and aunt. If it is from your father's side, it is paternal, okay? And when it is from mother's side, it is maternal, right? Now father of your wife or husband is father-in-law. Same way mother of your wife and husband is mother-in-law. Now this is an important one, please remember. Father's or mother's only son or daughter is you yourself, okay? So you yourself is the father's or mother's only son or daughter. Whenever there is an example which says that you are the only, or this person is the only son or only daughter of your father and mother, then that means they are talking about you, okay? Son or daughter of your uncle or aunt is nothing but the cousins or the cousin. Son of brother or sister is nephew, and daughter of brother or sister is niece, okay? Then wife of your son is daughter-in-law, husband of your daughter is son-in-law, okay? Read the rest of them, by heart them, try to relate it to your own family, okay? Try to relate it to your own family so that you will be able to remember the names, right? Let's move on to sums and let us see how to solve them. Question number one. Rupesh introduces Poonam as the daughter of only son of my father's wife. How is Poonam related to Rupesh? Welcome to the first category of sums under blood and relations. Now in this category of sums, what happens is that there is a person who is introducing other person, or there is a person like say Rupesh, he is saying that Poonam is this and that related to my father or my mother or something like that. Okay, in these type of sums, the best way to handle these sums is trace back from last, or trace backwards, trace from last. Let us see how to handle. Okay, we can draw this, we can solve this using a diagram also, but it is much preferable to trace from last. This is the easiest method. Now what is the sentence? Rupesh introduces Poonam as the daughter of the only son of my father's wife. This is the main sentence from where we'll get the relation. What is the last thing? My father's wife. Now instead of Rupesh, consider yourself in the place of Rupesh. So my father's wife is nothing but my mother. Okay, my mother, okay, my father's wife is my mother. Only son of my father's wife, we have already learned, when they give only son or only daughter, and if it is you, then we have to consider it, they are talking about you. So only son of my father's wife means only son of my mother, and I am a boy, okay? So only son of my mother will be me, myself, okay? So me. So daughter of the only son, so my daughter, okay? That means that Poonam is my daughter, right? So instead of me, now we'll put Rupesh. That means Poonam is Rupesh's daughter. How is Poonam related to Rupesh? Poonam is daughter of Rupesh. So daughter is the answer. Always remember, trace from last. It would be very easy to solve such sums. You don't need diagram also, just little bit of writing here and there and you'll be able to solve. Let us see next sum. Question number two. Introducing a girl, a boy said she is the daughter of the mother of the daughter of my aunt. How is the girl related to the boy? Again, very easy. We have seen these kind of sums. This is the first category where we trace from the Last, what is the sentence? She is the daughter of the mother of the daughter of my aunt. Let us start. Now, instead of boy, you will consider yourself. My aunt. Okay. This is me. Okay. These are my parents. Okay. This is my father. This is my mother. So, let us assume that my aunt. So, mother's sister. Okay. This will be my aunt. Correct. This is the aunt. Daughter of my aunt. Okay. This is the daughter of my aunt. Right. This is the daughter of my aunt. Okay. So, we have this. We have this. Mother of the daughter of my aunt. Daughter of the aunt, mother of daughter of my aunt is nothing but again aunt itself. So we have come over here, again daughter of the mother. So this is mother, that is aunt. Daughter of the mother is again this. So this is nothing but the girl. And we know aunt's daughter is nothing but, we both are cousins. So the boy and the girl are cousins. So how is the girl related to the boy? The girl is a cousin to the boy. Moving to next question. Question number 3. U plus V means U is brother of V. W minus X means W is the father of S. X divided by Y means X is sister of Y. Y multiplied by Z, YXZ, means Z is the mother of Y. Which of the following means that N is the mother of O? Welcome to category 2 of blood relations and family tree. By far, this is the most feared topic and one of the most confusing topic or type of sums related to blood relations. Okay, now in these sums the problem arises because of these symbols, and we are not able to visualize these symbols. So it is very, very important to visualize these symbols, because the answer which we need is in form of a relation and it is not in form of a symbol. Okay, so the relation which is there, we are given 4 options and we are not able to see what exactly these symbols mean or how they look when we draw a tree, family tree. That is the reason we are not able to quickly find the answer. So let us now see how to handle these kind of sums. Okay, now what do we want? We want which of the following means that N is the mother of O. For mother, the symbol is X. Y, X, Z means Z is the mother of Y. So N is the mother of O means O, X, N. Simply in the all the 4 options, first of all, check out which all options has O, X, N directly. This does not have this, does not have this, does not have this has. So this is our answer. Now here you directly got the answer based on the symbol, but 99% of times you will never get the correct answer directly or so easily. You may have to draw the diagram or try some elimination techniques. We are going to see those things ahead in the next sum. Okay, but here just to show you how easy also it can be, we took this example. Now again, one more thing I want to point out is that here we want O, X, N. That means we want a relation between O and N, correct? So which all option has O and N over here? This one has O and N. This has O and N. This has O and N in it. O, N is not over here. Okay. So this can never be the answer. So this is sort of an elimination technique. Okay. Which you can use. Again, one more example of elimination technique. We want N as mother of O. Correct. Here we have relation between N and O as N minus O. W minus X. Okay. Means W is father of S. Or W is father of X. It should be X. Okay. W is father of X. So here N minus O, it would be N is father of O. So this also relation is not useful to us. In this way, you can eliminate options. Okay, let's move on to next question. Question number 4. If A hash B means A is the mother of B, A minus B means A is the brother of B, A percent B means A is father of B, A multiplied by B, A x B means A is sister of B, which of the following shows that P is the maternal uncle of Q? Now the real problem starts. What we want? Say this is me. Okay. This is my mother. Okay. This is my mother. And this is the brother of my mother. And this brother of my mother will be my maternal uncle. Okay. This would be the relation of maternal uncle and nephew. So P is the maternal uncle of Q. So Q should be over here instead of me. And P should be over here. Okay. Now, is there a direct relation like someone is mother of Q and P is brother of someone? Okay, so it becomes very difficult to check like that directly. Such relations which are there going here and here, there is no relation. In last sum we saw OXN was N is mother of O. So this was very direct. But such a direct relation is not available over here. So what to do in such cases? We want a relation between P and Q. So which all options have P and Q in it? Okay, this one has P and Q, this one has P and Q, this one has P and Q. Okay, we cannot eliminate directly. Okay, based on that. So what to do? Best is draw a diagram for each option. Okay, you might think that it is a waste of time and all that stuff, but actually it is not a waste of time. It would be very, very helpful and very easy. Okay, let us see. Let us start from say option number 1. Okay, what is it? Q dash N. What does that mean? A dash B means A is brother of B. So Q and N are brothers. Okay, N hashtag M. So A hashtag B, A hash B is, A is mother of B. Okay, so N is mother of M. Correct. Now MXP means AXP, X means sister. So A is sister of B, M is sister of P. Now this relation of between Q and P. No, Q comes. Now take a look over here. We have learned that every new generation has to come on next level. Correct. Over here, the uncle is on this level, higher level, and I am on the lower level. So over here, what is happening? I am over here at the upper level. Uncle is at the P is at lower level. So this is not the answer. Okay. So cancel this option. Okay. Let us move on to the second option. What it is? P hash S. That means P is the mother of S. Okay. S X N. S is sister of N. Okay. That means that S and N are sisters. Okay. So we'll have, I'll write again over here. P is mother of S. S is sister of N. For siblings, what we have done? We have already shown an arrow. Okay. We'll use double edged arrow for siblings. So S is sister of N. Okay. And N dash Q. N is father of Q. Now uncle is only one generation ahead. Here P and Q are two generations. Q to this is one generation. This to this is another generation. So this is not the answer. Okay. Another way we could have what we'll say is that cancelled this relation is, what do we want is P is maternal uncle. That means P is male. Okay. Over here, what do we see? P hash S means A hash B is, A is mother of B. P is mother of S. That means P becomes female over here. Okay. You could have cancelled the option over here only. There was no need to calculate so much. But the reason I calculated the entire thing was to show how to draw the diagram. Okay. And to eliminate. Okay. So in exam, when you see P is male, okay, and here you are getting P as female, cancel this option. Let's move on to the, let us say, fourth option. This looks easy. Let us see what it is. Q dash S. That means Q is father, Q is brother of S, right? Q is brother of S. So siblings we show by this, right? Now Q is brother of S. S percentage P. Percentage means father. S is father of P. Again P, P and Q. B comes at lower level, so this is not the option. What remains is third. Okay, so this is the answer. But let us draw, let us not keep it to assumption. P dash M, that means that P is father of M, P is brother of M, sorry. So I'll draw it somewhere else. Okay, I'll draw it over here. Okay, what it is? P dash M hash N multiplied by Q. P is brother of M. Okay, these are siblings. P is brother, male. Okay, now P is brother of M. We do not know gender of this. M hash N. Hash means what? Mother. M is mother of N. Okay. N X Q. X means sister. N is sister of Q. That means these both are siblings. If they are siblings, that means M is mother of Q. Mother. So this is the relation. Paternal uncle. Like this. Okay. See how easy it was. Just draw diagrams for each and every sum of this kind. Right. Very easy. Let's move on. Also try to use first elimination techniques. If not, then go in for the diagrams. Moving to the next question. Question number 5. Read the information carefully and answer the questions. Okay. 1. A family consists of 6 members. P, Q, R, X, Y, Z. Q is the son of R, but R is not the mother of Q. P and R are married couple. Y is the brother of R. X is the daughter of P. Z is the brother of P. Now, based on these, there are 4 questions which we need to solve. Okay. Welcome to the third category of sums. Okay. Third and final category of sums that can be asked in blood and relations. Okay. Here, they'll give you some sentences. Based on that, you need to construct the family tree, and based on the family tree you need to solve the questions. Now this is the most productive kind of question in blood and relations. You can score a lot of marks over here because you just need to draw one family tree, and based on that you will be solving 4 questions. Each question, say if 1 mark, you'll get 4 marks, right? So it is pretty easier than what we the first 2 categories which we saw, or rather more scoring. Just remember, take your time. Even if you spend 30 seconds in drawing the entire family tree carefully, 30 to 40 seconds, you'll score. Just remember all the symbols and you'll be able to solve all the questions correctly, right? Now there is a family member having 6 members, P, Q, R, X, Y, Z. Q is son of R. Okay, so this is R and this is Q. So Q is son of R. Q is son, that means male. Okay, now this R, we do not know whether it is father or mother. Okay, what have they given? But R is not mother of Q. That means if R is not mother, okay, and Q is the son, then R has to be father. Father means plus sign. Now if there is father, there has to be someone as the mother. We do not know which person is that, so we'll keep it blank. Okay, now P and R are married couple. If P and R are married, R is the husband, so P will be the wife, correct? P will be the mother of Q, correct? So we'll have this as P and R are married couple, right? So we'll have a dash over here. Sorry, we use a dash for married couple, husband, wife, and we use arrows for siblings, right? So we have a dash over here for R and P. Now, Y is brother of R. Y is brother, so male. Y is male of R, so siblings. So double-edged arrow, okay? X is daughter of P. Now, P is over here and daughter of P is X. Daughter means female. Now, P and R are married couple. That means what will be Q and X? They will be brother, sister, siblings. Correct? Z is brother of P. Z is brother. That means male of P. Siblings. Correct? So, double arrows would be there. Right? Dash for husband, wife or married couple. Double arrows for siblings. Okay? And next generation is always written on the next line. Right? Now, let us see what have we given. Who is the brother-in-law of R? This is R. What is brother-in-law? He is the brother. Brother-in-law means wife's brother. So, answer is Z. Okay? How many female members are there in the family? One. This is one. This is two. There are two female members. How is Q related to X? This is Q. This is X. They are siblings. Or you can call them Q is brother of X. Right? Q is brother of X. They are siblings. Or better or more precise answer is Q is brother of X. Okay? Next, it depends on options also. If they give you siblings as option and there is no option as brother and sister, then you can write siblings. Okay? But if they give you siblings, brother, sister, then brother has to be marked. Right? Now, question number 4. How is Y related to P? This is Y. This is P. Simply, Y is the husband's brother. That means Y will be brother-in-law of P. Brother-in-law of P. Y will be brother-in-law of P. See how easily you got all the four answers by just drawing one diagram. Spend 45 seconds to draw the diagram and get full marks for all the four questions. Draw accurate diagrams. Moving to next question. Ashwini is Kiran's sister. Komal is Kiran's mother. Dipen is Komal's father. Isha is Dipen's mother. Then how is Ashwini related to Dipen? Now this is a third category sum. Okay, only sentences are given in a straight line. Okay, and there is only one question. So let us see how to solve it very easy. Ashwini is Kiran's sister. Okay, this is Ashwini. This is Kiran. Ashwini is Kiran's sister. So minus. Ashwini is minus and sister. So siblings. Okay. Komal is Kiran's mother. We do not know gender of Kiran, whether it is male or female. So we'll write plus minus. We do not know which it is. So we'll write both. Komal is Kiran's mother. Komal is mother. That means minus sign of Kiran. Dipen is Komal's father. Dipen father. So plus sign of Komal. Okay. This is Komal over here. And Isha is Dipen's mother. Isha is Dipen's mother. Mother means minus sign, negative. How is Ashwini related to Dipen? Ashwini and Dipen, okay? Dipen's daughter is Komal. Komal's whatever son or daughter or the child is Kiran. So, and Kiran's sibling is Ashwini. So, Komal's daughter is also Ashwini. One child is Kiran. Kiran's sister is Ashwini. So, Komal's daughter is also Ashwini. So, Ashwini and Dipen will be what? Grandfather and granddaughter. So, how is Ashwini related to Dipen? Ashwini is granddaughter of Dipen. See how easy it was? Moving to next question. There are six persons. Ashwin, Kiran, Komal, Dipen, Isha and Mittal. Komal is sister of Mittal. Kiran is brother of Isha's husband. Dipen is the father of Ashwin and grandfather of Mittal. There are two fathers, three brothers and a mother in the group. Who is the mother? Now, if you start counting father, then three brothers and just one mother, that is one female, then you won't get the answer. Best way is, this is third category sum. Find, draw the diagram. Okay, draw the diagram very easily. Let us start. Komal is sister of Mittal. This is Komal. This is Mittal. Since they are brother, sister, Komal is sister. Okay, we do not know whether Mittal is male or female. So, we'll have this. So, they can be sisters. They can be sister and a brother. Okay, next. Kiran is brother of Isha's husband. So, Isha has an husband. So, Isha is female. Isha is the wife. Okay, dash has a husband. We do not know who that person is. But he is male. That we know that. And brother of the husband is Kiran. Right? Now, what have they given? Dipen is father of Ashwin. Okay, so there is Dipen. He is the father. So, male of Ashwin. Okay, we do not know Ashwin is male or female. So, we'll write it like this because we should not deduce the gender based on names. Dipen is also the grandfather of Mittal. So, this diagram we'll write over here because we have Mittal over here. So, Dipen is over here plus sign. This is Ashwin. Okay. Now, we do not know whether it is plus or minus. Now, the family is consisting of six persons. There is no external person which they have hidden or something like that. Okay. So, what we should do, how to deduce. Now over here we know that Isha's husband we do not know. The only unknown factor is Isha's husband, but we know that the only unknown person whose relation directly has not been established is Ashwin. Okay, so Ashwin must be Isha's husband. So we'll have Isha over here. Ashwin is the husband, so plus, and the brother is Kiran, and Ashwin is the father of Mittal, right? Mittal, we don't know whether it is plus or minus. Say, let us assume that Dipen is the husband of Isha. Even if that is the case, our question is, who is the mother? So how will the diagram look if Dipen is the husband of Isha? It would look like this, okay? And Kiran over here, then Dipen, Ashwin, then the fate of these two people would be, again be not known, because we do not know how Ashwin and Mittal or Komal is related. We only know relation between Mittal and Dipen. So this is the most appropriate diagram. But even if this diagram you take, the question was, who is mother? The only mother over here is Isha. Komal is sister of Mittal. There is no evidence that Komal is married. So answer is Isha. We know Isha has an husband. So the only mother over here is Isha, right? So moving to next question. Question number 8. Pointing out to a lady, a girl said, she is the daughter-in-law of the grandmother of my father's only son. How is the lady related to the girl? Now this is a type 1 sum, okay? That means we have to trace from last. Now you might see this sentence and say, this is very, very easy. We can directly find the answer and all that stuff. But please be very, very careful, okay? Please check out all the possibilities. Let us see. This is a very tricky sum actually, okay? It's actually easy, but by twisting words, they have made it tricky. Let us see what exactly is the trick over here. My father's only son. Now generally we'll take, okay, I'm my father's only son, so they are talking about me. But actually no, you are a girl over here, okay? And they are talking about my father's only son, okay? So I'll write it over here, okay? The girl, so this is you. This is you. You are a girl right now over here. My father's only son. So my father has a son, okay? So my father has a son. That means this is nothing but he is my brother. So we are siblings. My father's only son. Grandmother of my father's only son. Now the grandmother can be father's mother, okay, or your mother's mother, okay? It can be any possibility. This is also a grandmother, this is also a grandmother, right? Grandmother of my father's only son. Both are grandmothers. Daughter-in-law of grandmother of my father's only son. Daughter-in-law of these grandmothers. Now this grandmother's daughter-in-law is nothing but your mother, correct? Right? Or it, there can be another child also, but let us consider this as it can be your mother, or this grandmother's daughter-in-law is what? There must be a son, and then there must be a wife to this son, and that would be daughter-in-law of this grandmother, and that daughter-in-law will be your aunt, okay? Or the son's aunt, or your aunt also, since you are siblings, right? So it can either be your mother or your aunt, so you cannot determine the answer for sure. So the answer is, can't be determined. You cannot simply write it as your mother, because grandmother can be from your father's side or mother's side, right? So remember always that you need to read it carefully. Moving to next question. A's mother is sister of B and daughter of C. D is daughter of B and sister of E. How is C related to E? Again, this is a category 3 sum. Okay, let's draw the diagram. A's mother, okay, A's mother. Mother, we do not know who the mother is, okay, she is female, is the sister of B and daughter of C's daughter, okay, C's daughter is mother is sister of B, okay, we do not know whether B is plus or minus or male or female, and mother of A, D is daughter of B and sister of E, so this will be D is sister of E, okay, right? How is C and E related, they have asked. Now these two are brother sister or sister sister, right? Either male or female, so siblings. C's next generation is this, okay, children, and children's children means grandfather or grandmother, okay? We do not know what exactly is C can be father of this, or C can be mother of this, these children, okay? It is just given A's mother is daughter of C. They have never mentioned whether C is male or female. We do not know. So it is either grandfather or grandmother. Moving to next question. Question number 10. In a family of 6 persons, A, B, C, D, E and F, there are 2 married couples. D is grandmother of A and mother of B. C is wife of B and mother of F. F is the granddaughter of E. Who among the following is one of the couples? Okay, so they have given us 4 options. This is type 3. Let us start constructing the diagram. डी इज ग्रैंडमदर ऑफ ए, सो वील हैव ए ओवर हियर, वील हैव डी ओवर हियर, देयर इज अ जनरेशन गैप, टू जनरेशन गैप्स, एंड मदर ऑफ बी, सो डी इज मदर ऑफ बी, सो डी इज फीमेल, ओके, सी इज वाइफ ऑफ बी, सो बी मस्ट बी मेल, एंड सी इज वाइफ, सो फीमेल, एंड मदर ऑफ एफ, सो सी इज मदर ऑफ एफ, एफ इज द ग्रैंड डॉटर ऑफ ई, नाउ एफ इज ग्रैंड डॉटर ऑफ ई, सो हियर वील हैव ई, राइट, who is related directly to F, okay, who among the following is one of the couples, now over here what have they given, C and B are husband wife, so any options which includes C and B not together, that gets cancelled, here C and D is given, so C is coupled with B, so this cannot be our answer, here B and E is given, not the answer, so we have to check whether it is this or none of these, okay, now here they have given is that D is grandmother of A and F, E, F is granddaughter of E, so D and E possibility is there that they are a couple because there is no other place where you can place E and complete the diagram, say if you place E below over here somewhere or it has to be two blocks above F, okay, and two blocks above F is only D, so these both have to be husband and wife, and over here also here we know that D is grandmother of A, so A must be sibling with F, okay, and A must be the child of B and C, okay, so just remember over here that there is no other way that all these conditions get satisfied, E has to be over here, two blocks or two generations above F, this is the first generation above F, this is the second generation above F, so because E is nothing but the grandfather of, F is the granddaughter of E, so E has to be over here, and since it cannot happen that D is also female, E is also female, because they have given two married couples, now A and F, for A and F they have not mentioned whether they are married couple or anything like that, so we have to take that they are not married, one married couple we know, so the other married couple has to be the grandfather and grandmother, that is D and E, so this is the answer and not this, see how easy it was, moving to next question, pointing to a photograph the man said the lady in the photograph is my nephew's maternal grandmother, how is the lady in the photograph related to man's sister who has no other sister, this is type 1 sum with a small twist, okay, because here it is not relation between man and the lady in the photograph, it is relation between lady in the photograph and the man's sister, okay, who has no other sister, what have they given, let us trace from the last, what have they given, my nephew's maternal grandmother, this is me, correct, this is the man, this is me, nephew means either my brother's son or my sister's son, that we do not know, okay, so we'll have a nephew over here, okay, nephew, nephew's maternal grandmother means nephew's mother, right, nephew's mother and mother's mother, that is the maternal grandmother, right, we have seen maternal word is used for mother side, paternal, P, paternal is used for father side, so maternal grandmother, lady in photograph is maternal grandmother of my nephew, this is my nephew, so we do not know whether this nephew is of my brother or mother, now here they have given what is the relation between the lady of the photograph and my man's sister, that means my sister who has no other sister, so here we have to assume that I am directly related as a brother to the mother of my nephew, that means this is my sister, okay, I have no other sister, right, so this is my sister and he is my nephew, so what is the relation between the lady in photograph and my sister, they are nothing but mother and daughter, so lady in the photograph is mother of my sister or lady in photograph is mother of the man's sister, see how easy it is only a little bit twisting of words, but if you pay close attention, draw the diagram, you will be easily able to deduce what the relations are, the only thing you need to do over here is keep on practicing, more sums you practice, more and more you become well versed in blood relations, just keep on drawing diagrams, once you draw diagrams more and more, you will become very fast in it and very good at it, also remember the symbols plus for male, minus for female, siblings, double arrows, husband wife, dash, okay, this is wife, this is husband, and every generation is written on the next level over here, either this way you can write it or you can have husband wife and they have these children, so this is also correct, right, so whichever way you want, you just fix your own symbols, fix your own symbols and use them in exam, right. This ends the blood relation and family tree tutorial. Hope this helped you understand the strategy to be used while solving the blood relation sums. Share the video with friends and give it a like if you liked it. Leave your comments and suggestions for us. Also, do not forget to subscribe to our channel to stay updated about upcoming tutorials.